the officials of the YMCA, our toilet referee, Pete Pennant, umpire Rob Underwood, head line judge Jay Wood, line judge Rick Peterson, side judge Sean Shewalker, field judge Dylan Lurie, the electric clock operator Warren Fields, play clock operator Al Meeks. The officials of the Sonata Island here, officials of the association.
Okay, I got you.
74, number 78, Cooper D, number 88, Nate Butts. Captains of the Raiders, number 7, Grant Kinsley. Number 23, Carter Barrett. Number 66, Andy Sanders. And number 76, Christian Ross.
I think you'll see Coach Testament deep.
Not on the first play, but again, it's just a guard back.
Anderson's got two wide outs split out to the left. And a slot back on the right. The running back in there is Hayes Gunn. And we're going to fake it. Want to throw. Looking to go over the middle. Got a man wide open. That is Savage. And Savage across midfield in the Indian territory to the 45.
Keller Green.
42-yard line. That was Keller Green for Haverson Central.
Yeah, we started the game. Didn't even start Whittington out there at the wideout position, did we? I don't think. And we lined up tight end Keller Green. Trying to throw it to him from this year. He's a big target. And he gets his first chance in the first half.
Jonah Wilson, Whittington split right. One more. I'm not sure who that is. Run the shotgun. Stevens County's got a forefront. And we're going to run it. Give it to our head. No, we're going to fake it. And quarterback Parker's going to pull it around the right side on the stick. Across the 35 to the 30-yard line. Inside the 30 to about the 27-yard line. First down run for Carson Parker.
Yeah, really good all fake that time by Gardner.
Gangers down to the Indian 27-yard line.
Finally, want to throw it again. Parker has nobody for it. He can go right up the middle, and he'll get about 8 yards. Tackled around the 21-yard line. Carson Parker will get it again. Nothing there, Chris. Just tucked it in.
That's a quick move from here to his left. That's a quick screen. He didn't like what he saw. He looked straight ahead. And there's a big hole there. So it's hard to play by the second quarterback. He got it to 6 yards.
Keller Green's a tight end on the right. Got splits left. Savage, Whittington, and I believe that is Noah Wilson. I'm going to fake it and pull it again. Parker's got it. Parker's in loose. He can score. He's at the 5 and got tackled around the 2-yard line. Got a flag in the play.
Well, I want to say he got a really good block that time by Savage, but they're going to call holding on him. And that's going to bring it back. Unfortunately, it's a good run off the block. They're calling for holding. He's got his hands up in the jersey. The line of scrimmage and not the spot of the foul.
We bring Maverick Chitwood the ball in on Everett Brutusale. Wilson's out here on the near side as well. That's Jonah Wilson. A split right, I believe that's Whittington. Got two slots in there. Got a tight end right and a slot left. Gunn flips over to the left side. We're second down about 11. Got a man in motion. That's Whittington from right to left. And a play action. Going to dump it out there quickly. Got it. Caught by Savage. Savage to the to about the 21-yard line, maybe. Savage on the catch.
They came with a blitz that time. Parker had no choice but to get rid of it quickly. He did. The Savage out in the flat. Good positive game. He got two downs to pick up his 5 yards.
Linebacker Stevens County runs it and got and made the tackle. Now, third down, Chris. Third and about five. Split Wilson out right. Long Whittington. And I believe that's Chris. Got us tied in. First down, I think he's got it, Chris. He got across the 20. Got to keep across the 20, about the 15-yard line. Yeah, now the first down. Dawson Childs made the tackle.
Good blocking over there again. Running times the play. It's just wide open over there. Carson will have a good gun, and nice blocking gets the new set of down.
Chitwood, Whittington, and Wilson on this near side. Got a tight end right. Shotgun. Hayes Gunn doesn't take it. He pulled it. But our quarterback will pull it. Not much on that carry. He tries to go to the left side. Got to about the 11-yard line. Child and Swinton made the tackle for Stevens County.
That didn't look like it.
Well, you're a good 4 yards.
Almost five. So nothing wrong with that. Carson a lot here early on. We've seen him for 3 years. He's kind of straight to stick it up in there.
Parker in that shotgun. Hayes Gunn is to his right. We got tripped to the right. tight end left, and we pull it, going to throw it, going to gun it over the middle, and complete. It looked like it was intended for the Whittington, but I think somebody may have attempted it.
Well, I think he was trying to go to maybe Chipwood at the goal line, and they're looking right back to the sun, and it looks like Whittington Chipwood's had something right to see. He just couldn't pick it up. I don't think he was going to go with the gun right there.
This will be the ninth. He'll get it in. Touchdown. Touchdown, Haversham. He's got his first carry of the season, and he got a touchdown.
He was wondering, when am I going to get one? He's been in this drive 8 plays now. He's trying to get one behind the play of March. Great blocking. Just a big hole for it.
Michael Hill on to the end. And let's watch this here. And the snap hold kick is up. And good. Pound out of the foot. Haversham Central League 7-0.
All right, guys.
Commanded by Wick Street. Drive of the day. Fourth back.
Yeah. at the Fabricant Center of 43-yard line,
we just didn't cover it that well.
There's a little bit of wind. You thought he might have got to the end zone, but he kicked it right in the middle, right to their good returner, and he almost made us pay for a big one there.
Trip Underwood in the shotgun, hands it off to his running back, and not much room this time for Javon Gordon, the junior running back. And he got to about the 42-yard line.
Hensley back there immediately.
Maybe a yard on the carry. It's going to be second down and nine. They're at Haversham's 42-yard line. Stevens County will split two to each side. Or check it, they'll split a single set over to the left side. Got two on the right. They're in that shotgun. Quarterback has it, fakes it, wants to throw, looks, going to go over the middle and then knocked down. I think that was Wilson that got
Wilson,
a hand on it.
Yeah. They hadn't mentioned his name on this defense, but he's a really good defensive player, too, to go along with Barrett and Hensley. And he just looks like a football player, too. And he's also going to play some wide out. Got a lot of experience on that defensive side of the ball, and that's a good play right there. He almost had a chance to get a pick.
Third down and nine at the Haversham's 42-yard line. Stevens got the ball. We got two on the right, got a split left. That's Smith over there on the left side. Gordon's a running back. They want to throw and going to go a little screen. They got it off to Gordon. Gordon, oh, he got broke one tackle. And the second man can't bring him down, and he's still on his feet, and he goes out of bounds. Looks like he got enough for a first down to the 30. Just couldn't bring him down.
Well, he saw that athletic ability and that strength. We had a blitz coming. They let us penetrate because they had a screen called. And we still had one there to make the play, but he had to make the individual tackle out in open space and unable to do it. And he's able to pick up the first down after the missed tackle.
And last pass play was 12 yards. We're going to give it to Gordon again. He's going to try to jump outside. We got him by the legs.
He was going to try to bounce it outside and look for something. Hensley said, no, thank you. I'm going to chase you down from the backside and make the tackle for a loss in the backfield.
Second down. And a shotgun. Underwood's got it. Fakes it. Wants to throw. Coming to the near side. Going to be high and overthrown. Pass intended for Smith again. To seek Smith, the senior wideout. He's had a good ball game so far, but this was just a little too high for him.
Well, I'll tell you what, Mark, we put Sadaphone on an island out there, didn't we? I mean, he was man-to-man with no free safety up anywhere near it.
So it's going to be third down. Third and 11, Chris. We're probably in four down territory, wouldn't you think?
Could be. Depends on what they're faced with here after this third down.
They're at Haversham's 31-yard line. Underwood in that shotgun. And they play action. They want to throw, looking, forced out of the pocket. Going to go long and high, overthrown. And no, he made a super catch. Wow.
How did he catch that ball? We were maybe holding him at about the five.
And I thought it was well overthrown.
Well, we kind of let him go for some reason. It looked like Mark there thinking maybe it was overthrown. And, boy, he made one heck of a catch. We were thinking our defensive backs that he might not have caught it, but immediately they gave the signal for a touchdown.
Yeah, we had two Raiders right there with him at the goal line. And, really, Daly had him by the jersey. They really could have caught defensive holding. And he had to come back toward the goal post to make the play back over his right shoulder. And that's where they made the play. He made a great catch.
And they bobble the extra point. And Haversham leads it 14-6. 4:07 to go here in this first quarter play. Haversham leads 14-6 after that Stevens touchdown. Let's take a commercial break. We'll be right back. Player re-intro, another one. Do a scoring drive. Same. Yeah.
Orders
Welcome back here to Raiders Stadium. The Kinetic by Windstream scoring drive for Stevens County after the long kickoff return. Six play, 43-yard drive gets them on the board. Extra point was no good. We lead 14-6.
They kick it off to Hayden Gailey, and Gailey going to be brought down around the 26-yard line. So Gailey got the short kick and returned it for a few to about the 26-yard line, I guess, Chris.
Yeah, and that touchdown throw by Tripp Underwood to his receiver, Jose Smith, 31-yarder, heck of a catch he made in the back of the end zone. I didn't think he had a chance to kind of.
I didn't either.
Rerouting himself and catching that ball, but he did. And but when you miss that extra point, kind of takes the life out of it for you a little bit. And so let's see if Habersham can match that scoring drive of Stevens County with another one of their own.
Habersham moving right to left. They're on that left hash. They got three wideouts bunched up together on this near side or the short side of the field. And we got a tight end right. We got a man in motion. That's Savage. Sets up on that right side, and we're going to keep it quarterback. Now you're going to dump it out there to, let's see, was that Savage?
Savage,
yeah. Came back.
Run option pass. He's got that option like Mark talked about. He just flipped it out there to him. Able to pick up 4 yards because Carson wasn't going to be able to run that one for 4 yards.
Second down. Got 4 yards. Second down, six at our own 31-yard line.
Boy, Coach Tankersley really working that line judge over there on the sidelines over on that particular call.
Stevens has a five front. We got a man in motion from right to left. That's Savage. Now he goes back from where he came from. Sets up. And we're going to run Hayes Gunn. He's got a little hole. He's at the 35 to the 40 and thrown down. Maybe to the 41-yard line.
Mark has a good chance. Hayes Gunn is going to always finish going forward when he gets tackled. He's a big, hard runner.
Yeah, it's going to take more than one person to bring him down. He gets that load of steam going, and if I was a defensive back, I wouldn't want to have to tackle him by myself. So he's a good runner, strong runner. He's going to wear them down. If he keeps it up, he'll wear that defense down by the third, fourth quarter.
Swinton made the tackle for the Indians at linebacker. That was a 10-yard run for Hayes Gunn. First and 10, right around 41-yard line. Parker puts a man in motion. That Savage takes a snap. Fakes it, wants to throw, going to be incomplete. Looking for Whittington, short hopped it. It's going to be second down and 10.
I think Carson just threw that one away, really, into the ground. He saw double coverage. Zeke's going to see a lot of that, it looks like. And Carson had pressure in his face, but I think he recognized the coverage pretty quickly, too, and just threw that one about 5 yards short.
Second down 10. We're at our own 41-yard line. We're on that left hash, working toward the scoreboard here at Raiders Stadium. Hayes Gunn is your running back. You got Trips to the right. They've got a five front. One standing up, four with their hand on the ground. Got a man in motion, that's Savage. And we fake it. We want to roll right, looking to throw it on the run. We caught by Savage. Savage can't break the first man that got him and brought him down. That was Brock Tankersley, the junior. And it's going to be third down.
Tell you what, Mark, Tankersley is going to that side judge after every play. It's just crazy to see.
It must be some kind of alignment because we're doing a lot of motion. We're changing people that were on the line to off the line. Evidently, he's seeing we don't have enough men on the line of scrimmage. Real quick, I want to go back to that previous play. In years past, Carson would have tried to force that ball in. He didn't. He threw it in the ground when he went in there, showing maturity there.
Third down and eight. Parker's got it, looking to the near side. Going to be caught by Whittington. Whittington's got a little red. He's got some room. He's at midfield, 45, and pushed out of bounds. He got the first down, Chris. He got across midfield where he got the first. He got pushed out of bounds around the 43-yard line. Pushed out by Swinton.
Yeah, just a little quick screen out here. And everybody thought Zeke would take it back to the inside. He used that quickness and speed to get to the sideline and pick up the first down. Boy, we really needed that first down. You kind of sensed you needed to try to keep this ball in your hands offensively if you're Habersham.
As a 14-yard pass play, first and 10, we're at Stevens' 43-yard line. Parker in that shotgun. Hayes Gunn is still back there with him. And we fake it to him. We're going to try to throw and dump it out there. Got it caught right at the line of scrimmage. Then we lost it. Did it go out of bounds?
Went out of bounds.
Okay.
And they'll call it a fumble, too.
Who caught it? That was Jonah Wilson.
Yeah. He caught it, ran forward a couple yards, and then it was knocked out of his hands forward. A big gain of about 3 yards on that fumble.
Dawson Childs, the linebacker, made the hit for Stevens.
Oh, getting a lot of push on the edge in Carson's face all of a sudden.
Starting to get late in this first quarter, down to 1:47 to go in the quarter. We're up 14-6. Second down seven. We're at Stevens' 40-yard line. We're on the right hash. We got the wide side to the left. We got two wideouts on the left. Parker slaps his hands, hands it off to Gunn. Gunn making some nice moves, and he'll have a first down to about the 30-yard line. Nothing, just hard running that time, Chris.
Yeah, just they made a nice little skip move there too to make somebody miss, and just a nice little run there by Gunn. That's four carries, 33 yards for him.
That was a 10-yard run. Childs and Smith, Santana Smith, made the tackle. So now it's first and 10. We're at the Indian 30-yard line. This will be the eighth play of the drive. 90 seconds to go here in this quarter. We're up 14-6. Parker in a shotgun. Parker takes it, play action, forced out of the pocket, having a roll right, throws it to the last second. Can he call for Harrison Central down the far side? Got a flag. He's pushed out of bounds. Got a flag on the play. Probably a block in the back, Chris.
Could be.
Let's check it.
Good recognition, though. Boy, Carson looks really comfortable out there in the pocket. Even with early pressure in his face, he's able to use his feet to get out of the pocket and keep his eyes down the field.
Official still.
That went to Everett Rudisill getting his first catch from that tight end position. But we'll see what the call is. Like I say, probably a block in the back or a holding. Ineligible man downfield, looks like.
Yep. All right, so one of the offensive linemen, I guess, got down there maybe. So back us up to the 35-yard line. First and about 14, maybe 15. Still first down, though, Chris. First down and 15, we'll say. Got trips on the short side of the field. That's to the right. And a little reverse. And we want to throw it. Got a man open. That is Rudisill. He's got it at the 15 to the 10 and knocked down. How about that? Zeke Whittington played a little quarterback. Threw it down the field to Rudisill.
I like that call. Somebody, you think, well, we're going to save that one. Right now you got 14-6 lead. You got great field position. Zeke, who played quarterback in middle school, can throw the football. Unable to really get a lot on him because he had somebody rushing him and had to kind of throw it off his back foot, but it was enough to get there, and big play by Evershaw.
Hayes Gunn, first down and 10, is going to take the handoff right up the gut. He makes some nice moves dancing through there, and he'll get down to about the 6-yard line. Hayes Gunn on the carry for the Raiders.
Yeah, he's got good feet there. I mean, he's a big, stocky kid, but he's sidestepped some people with some good footwork there in the middle of all that traffic.
Hoseclaw made the tackle. Got a reserve coming in for Hayes Gunn. It's Donnie Warren, looks like. Got a new back in there, Donnie Warren.
I don't remember. Do we see him in the scrimmage?
I don't recall. Second down. Parker takes it, fakes a pitch, and keeps it. Tucks it up in there and got maybe a yard. That'll be it. So Parker kept it.
Yeah, just really wasn't anything there. He had two defensive players just staring him in the face. He could have pitched it to Warren, but he let it kind of split him and see what he could get. Bring up third and about seven.
And now that's the end of the quarter. That's the end of one quarter, 14-6. Haversham Central leads at the end of one. Commercial break. We'll be right back.
back to Raider Stadium. John Larry Blackfield will swap ends of the field as Eversham's going toward the open end, toward the softball field. Third and about six here from the, where we got that spotted, guys? About the 7-8 yard line?
Yeah, they're going to put it on the 8 officially. Third down and 7 so we can pick up a first. Parker in a shotgun. Parker takes it.
Busted play. Man, illegal. We had a wide receiver move over there.
Well, Benji's halfway out on the field.
Yeah. Not going to be real happy about that because you're just coming basically out of a timeout there as you switch ends of the field at the end of the quarter. And we kind of jumped and moved over there. We even really didn't even run the right play there out of the backfield. Parker, or Carson was going to fake it, but Gunn was going the opposite direction. So kind of shot ourselves in the foot there. Backs up, be third and 12 now.
Yep. Third down and 12 from the 13-yard line. Parker puts a man in motion from left to right. And nothing there. Wants to run it. Going to have to go right. Oh, now he throws it last second. And we had our intended receiver tripped up, but no call.
Whittington was coming back across the middle. Mark, you're down there looking at it. Boy, Coach Harrison's really wanting it and not getting it. And he just threw that hat down on the 15-yard line. Mark, were you able to watch Zeke in that route? I couldn't tell.
They said that he got knocked down by the player, but they said it was incidental contact, that his foot got caught up in there. We're saying he got pushed down. Coach Harrison is livid. He got a penalty. And they're saying that they just incidental contact, that he hit his foot on his cut, and it knocked him down. So,
and that flag, is that on?
And the flag
is that a warning?
It's my conduct on Coach Harrison running out onto the field.
Now you're taking yourself out of field goal range. I'd probably just go for it here, Mark, and try to throw something deep and see what happens. I mean, you could punt them deep, but it's too far for a field goal, I think.
Yeah, he's just going to go for it here. Punt, you're on the what? You trust your defense right now. Yeah. You get a big touchdown a while ago on a great, great catch. It was really an overthrow. So you got him down to 28. Let's just go for it. Fourth and I don't know what your fourth and 25 call is, but I agree with the call. Don't too far for a field goal. He's going to call timeout and talk it out.
All right, let's take a time, too. 11:52 to go here in this first half. Haversham Central leads 14-6. Short break. We'll be right back.
Stadium, fourth and 25 after the unsportsmanlike penalty on the Haversham bench. Coaching staff were backed up to the Stevens County 28-yard line.
All right, Parker has got it. Let's see, fourth and 27. And he's going to roll around and throw it out there quickly to Whittington. Whittington's just going to try to find some room, 20 to the 15 and to about the – it actually pushed out of bounds around the 16. So that was just something just maybe to get a few yards.
Yeah. Yeah, just, yeah, hey, we'll no sense in punting it. You could have a bad snap, give them the ball a great field position, and instead you just go for it and turn it over to them. They'll start this drive from their own 15-yard line. You'd take that.
We don't have a flag on the play, do we?
I don't think so. Yeah, maybe we do.
Yeah, we got a flag.
Mark, what do we got?
What you got, Mark? Yeah.
I'll tell you one
I'm
thing.
I'm waiting to sort it out. Hold on, let me see.
Well, I'll tell you what I think it is.
After the play, unsportsmanlike.
Yeah.
contact.
Yeah, it's going to go against number 10. I think the coach
it's
is
still Stevens' ball, but it's
oh really
it's still Stevens' ball because it was after the
after
play.
After the play.
I think they were over here doing a little taunting.
Oh, they were doing a lot of taunting
on the sideline, and
yeah.
They must have said something running off the field because they didn't throw the flag where the play was on the sideline here. The flag was thrown in the middle of the field, so they must have kept jawing as they ran off. So it's after the play, so they get to keep the ball, but it moves the ball back down to about the 8-yard line.
Yeah, they definitely were doing taunting. I mean, they tackled Zeke inbounds at the 15 and really kind of got a little too excited, and you could tell they were saying stuff. And I mean, it's just a tackle on the 4th and 25 play, and
yeah.
you cost your team a few yards, but you know, lesson learned there. I think if you're Stevens County, they got to control their emotions a little bit when they tackle Zeke. There seems to be, you know, obviously this attitude that we're going to shut him down.
Rudisil's in there at linebacker for us. So Underwood's in that shotgun, puts Gordon in motion, slaps his hands and hands it off to Gordon. Gordon, not much over there on that right side, trying to run behind right tackle. Looks like Siance may have been in on that tackle.
Yeah, he ran into a brick wall there, blue jerseys.
Also, Hensley was there. Only got a yard, second down. Second down, 8. They got two wide outs, so they put one in motion, and they're going to toss it to him to try to run around that right side. And now he reverses, come back to the near side. He's almost in the end zone looking for a block, and he's going to get knocked down around the 10-yard line. Boy, he did a lot of running and really only got about a yard.
Yeah, he scared you for a second there,
yeah.
As he reversed field. But we had a lot of blue jerseys over here. It had good containment. And you're right, he ran a long ways to pick up 2 yards, but he also kept himself from getting tackled there back at the 2, which is what it looked like it was going to be. So Habersham with a big third down play here now as Stevens County has it on the 11, faced with about 3rd and 7.
Sonny Satterfone made that stop for Habersham Central on that 2-yard run. So it's going to be 3rd down and 7. They're at their own 11-yard line. They're in a shotgun. They got 2 wideouts on the short side of the field. A little play action. They want to throw it, and it's going to be, incomplete. Man, Smith almost made another great catch.
Yeah, he's a good-looking wide receiver.
Yeah.
I tell you, Mark, you keep putting Satterfone on an island out there against that kid. It's risky business. He looks pretty good.
You got a flag. I'm trying to wait and see what the flag gets. It's about halfway down the field. It might be like a defensive holding area for us. Nope, they got them on ineligible, so I'm sure we'll decline that, and they've got a punt. Yeah, but you're right now. He's a dangerous playmaker, number one, for them. He's a good player. You know, they had 2 good ones last year that they graduated. So Isaac Smith, number one for them, has taken over that lead receiver role. He made that great catch for a touchdown and almost made a diving catch right there in the middle of the field. You can tell that's where Underwood wants to go, is to him. And we're going to have to get some help for Satterfone, or it might be a big night for number one if they want to keep going him. We got to get more pressure on the quarterback. He had a lot of time to throw that ball, and we got to get on him and not give him that much time to look downfield.
Yeah, we get some pressure on him. I'll tell you what, Mark, you give Underwood some credit. He looks like a gunslinger, and he's got a really good arm. That was a bullet of about a 35-yard throw.
Yeah, Brandon Worley talked about that at pregame. He said he's got a quick release, and that ball comes out in a hurry, just like that one did there.
Luke Waters going to punt the ball away. Got an end-over-end kick. We're going to let it hit. And it gets a Raider bounce, and they down it around the 45-yard line. So pretty decent kick.
Yeah, pretty good. But Habersham will take the first down on the Stevens County 45-yard line. Good defensive stand there. You wanted to force them to punt that thing back to your offense, and that's what the defense did.
All right, so Habersham's offense coming back onto the field. Right now we're all huddled up with our head coach and offensive coordinator. I guess that's Benji Harrison. 10:03 to go in your first half. Habersham leads it 14-6. Stevens County missed an extra point. Habersham onto the field now, led by their center, Davey Sanders.
I was going to say, Dave, just always looking for a good positive play here on first down, especially when you start in your opponent's territory.
Now what are they doing?
Well, they had it spotted on the 44-yard line. I think it should have been the 45. Now they're getting everything adjusted.
Okay. So they move it. 1 little yard. First and 10 from the 45-yard line. Parker in the shotgun puts a man in motion. That's Whittington. And he's going to try to dump it out there to him, but he couldn't. And now he's going to make a couple of nice moves. He's at the 40, 35, 30 to the near side and pushed out of bounds. He wanted to get it back to Whittington, but then couldn't and made a bunch of nice moves and got down to the 35.
Oh, he looks quicker. Just some really good footwork we've seen from him. Not sure if that was a little bit of a busted play there. It looked like Zeke was coming in motion as the ball was snapped and in an odd spot to be in motion. And once again, a little bit of quick pressure on Carson. And, well, he made the most of it, though, by getting out of trouble.
Gave him 16 yards, first and 10 from the 29-yard line of Stevens County. Parker, they jump offside. Yeah. Hard count there, I guess.
Yeah, got him on a little hard count that time, and all four of them up front jumped.
So it'll be first and five now. Ball's going to be marked to inside the 25-yard line. Haversham working left to right toward the ladies' softball field. Haversham leads 14-6, 9:54 to go here in the half. Parker has his running back to his left. That's Hayes Gunn. We got two wideouts on each side. And we give it a gun. He just barrels right forward and not much at all, Chris. Going to be second down and five. Maybe a yard. I don't know.
Yeah, just good defensive stand there by the front four for Stevens and nowhere to go for Gunn.
Tackle was made by Lunsford, one of those defensive linemen, the nose guard. So this will say no gain on the play. Second down and five. Second down and five. Parker stands up, looks back toward the sideline, walks up to the line, says something to them. We got 10 seconds on the play clock. Got three split to the left. And there's a snap. Play action, looks to throw, looks. Come to the near side, still looking, has time. Looking, going to throw up a long bomb, and it's going to be incomplete.
And Coach Harrison's probably over there saying, do not throw that. Don't throw it, Carson. And he threw it anyway. He really just had nowhere to scramble. So he wanted to try to throw it, but there was just nobody on the right side of the field for him to throw it to. And didn't come out of his hand very well, and he made the cardinal sin of throwing it back across the field. And, boy, we got away with that one.
That's when you just tuck it and get what you can.
Yeah.
Third down, third and five at the 24-yard line. This will be the fourth play of the drive. Haversham working left to right. We're on that right hash. Got two wideouts to the far side. Whittington's out there along with Barrett. Parker takes it, gives it right off to Hayes Gunn, and he's not going to be close to the first. He got to about the 20. That's it. Had to get to the 19.
Close enough to go for it, I think.
Going to bring in maybe our heavy package, Chris, as Antonio Cantrell comes in.
Just short of the 20, you got to get to the 19.
Bring in their tight end. Still have two wideouts over there on the far side. It's going to be fourth and a long 1 yard. Cantrell's in there running back. He's to the left of the quarterback. They stand up, look back toward the bench. Fourth down and one. And we give it off to Cantrell, and Cantrell's going to have the first down.
Boy, he barely got the hand off, and then we came. They're acting like they stopped us, but we're getting
I think we got a – I thought we had it.
Mark, that's right there in front of you.
It looks a little short. He had to get across the 21, and he's just short of the 21. They're going to measure it to be sure, but I don't think he got it. It looks like it's about a half a football short from where I'm standing. There might be some room. I can't see that far. I don't have my glasses on, but it's going to be about a half a ball short.
Had a little bit of the mesh in the backfield was not good. The timing was not good, and he kind of handed it off to him late. But I thought he got a really good surge up in there and got to the 19. But
they did good. They did a good job of second, third contact there. They kind of stood him up, and it looked like he was going to fall forward, and they hit him a couple more times and stopped his momentum just short. That's AC's first carry, so he probably wasn't ready just to go straight downhill right off the bat. But it's going to be just a hair short. Tough luck. We had first and five there after a short punt, gives them the ball back. But, hey, we got our defense has been playing solid. We gave up one long touchdown pass, but other than that, they've been solid. We got the ball deep in their territory. We got to get the ball back by our defense there.
Hey, you got to be disappointed, though. You didn't get points there. I know Coach Harrison is. But watch Stevens County here on this first play. They may elect to go to the air and try to take advantage of us.
8:07 to go in the half. Haversham up 14-6. Stevens back out there offensively, led by their quarterback, Tripp Underwood, the junior. He's going to be in a shotgun. Gordon is your running back. They got three wideouts, two on the right, one on the left. Underwood taking his time, has it now. Hands it off to Gordon. He makes one man miss him in the backfield, and he slides up or got knocked down around the 19.
Yeah,
around the 19, 20-yard line. No gain on the play, Chris.
Big good penetration, made him hop, skip, and dodge somebody, but couldn't get to the edge. So good defensive play there by the Raiders.
7:44, clock's rolling. Second down, 10. Second down and 10. They're still in that shotgun. Got a split left, got a slot right, and they want to play action. They want to throw, forced out of the pocket. Underwood looking to run, going to throw long, and it's going to be incomplete. Incomplete. Carter was back there on the coverage, Chris.
Great coverage by Barrett. I mean, he was running stride for stride, found the football, and turned and made a good play on it. Coach Tankersley, I think, is going to argue every play tonight.
Is that him that's arguing now?
Okay. I mean, every single play he's been in that poor guy's ear.
Third down and 10. Clock is stopped with 7:18 to go here in the half.
Well, that was good coverage by Barrett. Maybe there was a holding somewhere prior to it, but we at least forced Underwood out of the pocket that time, and he had to throw that one on the run. Got some pressure on him. Let's see if we come with a blitz here on third and 10 or just kind of play it a little bit safer and keep everybody in front of you.
And play action. Underwood gets it off there and incomplete. He had time, but he had to hurry there at the very last. He was looking for his tight end, but and it fell short, incomplete.
Yeah, he had him open, too, and we missed the coverage on him as he was going to be able to pick up the first down. But it was underthrown. As you said, a little bit of pressure makes him throw it with a – you know, instead of just sitting there with nobody in your face, that's much easier. So another good defensive stand there with a chance to give Haversham another opportunity at great field position.
Luke Waters is in to punt the ball away. We got Barrett and Whittington back. Snap is good and got away the kick, a beautiful kick. Returnable, well, maybe not. It's going to be out of bounds.
Oh, yeah, it's maybe get marked way back short of the 50.
Let's see where they go, Chris.
Referee back here hadn't dropped his hand yet.
Wow.
Yeah, about the 44.
Okay. Timeout on the field, 7:04 to go. Let's take us a little extra time here, Chris.
Yeah, they are. Boy,
that was just a regular timeout.
Yeah.
I guess because of the heat, maybe.
Maybe so. Cooled down here in the booth about 2 degrees or four. 78, not too bad. We've been up here plenty of times first game of the year where it's still been 90.
I'll never forget that game down at Cedar Shoals one day in Athens.
Oh, Lord. No doubt the hottest press box that we've ever been in.
I lost 20 pounds that night.
It was so hot. It never cooled off.
First down and 10. Parker's by himself in the backfield. He's got a man in motion from right to left. Going to toss it to him. And he's coming to the near side and got a flag on the play.
They're going to call a hold out there. That's a tough break because whoever that was blocking just really had his guy just driven into the ground. And they're going to call a hold on him. Tough break. Well, Terrison's going to argue and it won't do any good. It just happened to be right in front of that one. And I was watching him block. I think that was Everett Rudisil, number 19. He just really just kind of drove his guy into the ground. And
well, they called it as holding.
Yeah.
Okay.
They're going to call holding on him. Yeah. I didn't see it that way, but. Tough break, right? Barrett in motion and tossed it to him, and he looked good running the football. Had it picked up, about 6 or 7 yards there.
It's going to be first and long now. Very long. First and about 19. Parker's in that shotgun. Has it, quick one out here to the near side. Caught by Whittington. Whittington can't break it loose. First man got him. That was Santana Smith.
I'll tell you what, he was just, I don't know, the late flag comes in. Oh, this is going to go against Stevens County. Because it came well after. Oh, now Zeke's throwing up his arms. But he's looking at Stevens County. Well, I guess he's asking them what they want to do. No.
Well,
what do we have? What's going on here?
Haversham's not retreating yet.
They're going to mark it off against Stevens, it looks like. But we haven't not received a signal.
They picked up the flag and put it in his pocket.
He came in and threw the flag after the play.
Personal foul, Stevens County.
Oh, he's going to call it.
Oh, offset.
Offsetting. Okay.
So, in essence, so no foul there. 6:34 to go here in half, 14-6. Haversham leads.
If you'll notice, every time Zeke has the ball or gets tackled, there's a little bit of extra involved from the white shirts.
Second down, 15, play action. We want to throw, going to go over the middle, and it's going to be caught, and we get hit around the 42-yard line. Who caught that one, Chris?
I couldn't get the number.
That was Savage. Yeah, Savage again, Landon Savage.
Somebody was coming right at him, and he stopped on the dime and sidestepped him and picked up a couple of more yards, but more importantly, Dodd's getting hit pretty hard. Going to bring up third and a manageable four from the 41-yard line of Stevens County.
Carter Barrett out. In comes Jonah Wilson. He's got trips to the left. Whittington, Savage, and Wilson tied in right. Third down, third about five. Play action. We want to throw in the gun. It's going to be caught for a first down and more to about the 25-yard line.
Wilson settled in right there at the 35 in the zone. And Carson saw him the whole way. Just a perfect throw, good catch by Wilson, and we moved the chains on a big third and four.
So it's a first down for Haversham. It's a 15-yard pass play, first and 10 for the Raiders. Working left to right, we're in the Navy, they're in the white. Parker sends a wide out to the far side of the field. Little play action looking for that man. No, we're going to go short, and it's going to be caught around the 17 and brought down around the 15.
That's Whittington with the catch. Another one, they're just going a little bit short routes and settling in front of the coverage. And
tackle was made by Dawson Childs, the linebacker.
That's enough to move the chains.
Whittington got it. They gave him 10 yards, first down. First and 10, we're at Stevens' 16-yard line. We're down to 5 minutes to go here. And in the first half. Habersham leads it 14-6. Parker in a shotgun, takes a snap, pulls it, has it. Oh, lost it and got knocked out of bounds.
We're going to have to call that.
Got a flag thrown in there, too. Got a very late flag.
Well, he threw it, and then he called it, and then he was trying to run with it, and it looked like he fumbled it out of bounds.
You talking about Parker?
Yeah. Yeah, he threw it.
Is that an illegal touching, maybe?
The ball came out of his hand, and he just caught it, but he wasn't trying to throw it, and I think it got knocked out of his hand. But, Mark, let's see. Harrison doesn't look like he acts
like it.
They're
saying it was intentional grounding, but Coach Harrison said he got hit when he threw it, and that's why he threw it out of bounds. So they're having a discussion. That's not in high school. High school's not out of pocket. They're saying he got hit when he threw it. That's what made the bad throw. So we'll see if Coach Harrison wins that argument, but they're not going. No, he said he got hit, so why he threw it out of bounds. They're saying no, he threw it out of bounds, intentional grounding.
I thought he just got knocked out of his hand. I didn't even see him trying to.
No,
throw
he
it.
Did. He tried to do a little shovel pass out of bounds, and he was getting pulled on when he threw it. He was getting hit and pulled down, but they're saying that wasn't enough to call the intentional grounding. That he did it on purpose, which he did.
All right, third or
second down.
Second down to long.
Man, this one we have good field position. Things weird keep happening.
Second down and long. Got Whittington in motion from right to left. And going to dump it out there to Whittington. Whittington can't get a block.
I was hoping Carson would recognize the fact that we didn't have it blocked well and not throw it to him. And we certainly didn't have it blocked well. That would have had no chance.
Fell incomplete. Let me bring up third down. And, boy, a long way to go, Chris.
Yeah, we're leaving opportunities right now on the field offensively. We've had the ball on this side of the field the entire second quarter and haven't been able to get in the end zone.
It's about third and 26.
Well, so you got two downs to get it, in my opinion.
Parker going to gum to the near side. Oh! Wow, almost intercepted. That was almost a pick six.
Yeah, he was gone. And we'd have to go the same thing back to the wide side of the field. Now we'll punt it.
Yeah.
Be the first punt of the game. And I thought we would probably test them deep there on third and long. Boy, Coach Harrison will have a few things to say to his quarterback after that one.
Injury timeout. Stevens has got a player with some cramps. 4:05 to go here in the half. Habersham leads at 14-6. Injury timeout. We'll be right back. Camden Meads in there to punt it away. Young sophomore with his first punt. Yeah, snap is a little high, but he got it and gets away a pretty good kick over to the near side. And it hits. And we're going to let it roll and get it, guys. And they stop it at the one, or did he get in?
Oh, they'll mark it at the one.
All right.
I thought they might have touched it initially. But no touch by Stevens County. Good punt away from him. Good high cut punt. And Means with his first punt of his career.
38
Stevens
yards.
Stevens County down at the 1 yard line. Can't get much better than that.
Yeah, 38 yard punt. Stevens offense checking onto the field.
Mark, I don't want to be negative, but we played this entire half on our side of the field, and we didn't score either any of those opportunities.
That's three times, Chris, that we had it down. I know Coach Harris is disappointed, but like you said, we've had penalties. We had the the unsportsmanlike, the grounding. So just kicking ourselves in the foot on their side of the field. Now they got to get out of their one. Let's see if we can get good. Oh, safety.
Yeah, they handed the ball off to Gordon, and Gordon is going to be knocked down in the end zone. And who was that?
Braden. Seven. Hensley.
All right, Braden Hensley, the junior, or rather senior linebacker, got in there for a safety. And we picked up 2 points there, Chris, 16-6 now. Well, you could just see that coming.
You could. I mean, they're in shotgun deep in the end zone. They hand it off to Gordon deep in the end zone. And Hensley, who's gotten penetration, when he sees that run, knowing that they're at the 1 yard line and they're handing it off 3 yards deep, there's no doubt where he's going. He's in the backfield tripping Gordon up. And that's the kind of kinetic by Windstream scoring drive you like. One play by Stevens County for a safety for Habersham Central gives us 2 points. Now they'll have to kick it off to us or punt, whichever one they choose to do. And with 3:49, we'll get the ball back again with decent field position. Remember, this doesn't happen from the 40-yard line. They're going to kick this thing from the 20.
Yeah. I tell you, I'd love to get Zeke Whittington loose.
Boy, me too. I'm moving
on
him
a kickoff.
I mean, they're going to kick it. And I think about where they're at, it's about where he'll probably field it, hopefully around the 25. We need good kick return blocking on this play.
Luke Waters will kick it away for the Indians. 3:49 to go in the half. Habersham leads at 16-6. And there's the kick. Punches it up there, and Satterfield will have it at the 26-yard line. Satterfield to the 40, 45, midfield. Satterfield to the near side, 40, 35, 30, 25, 20, 15, 10, 5, touchdown! Touchdown, Habersham Central and Satterfield. Oh, my, how about that for Habersham Central in that kickoff return?
You were immediately looking for yellow flags on the field, and there are none. Satterfield with a great return, showing some speed and getting an opportunity to make a play. He took advantage of it. Boy, Habersham really needed that, Mark. As you said, three possessions and no scores in their territory.
That was a 73-yard touchdown run there, Chris.
Yeah, you're right, Chris. They kick it away from Zeke. You can tell they are not going to kick it to Zeke Whittington. And Sony Sonnefeld made them pay that time for kicking it away from Zeke. Great blocking, too. Now, you got to give credit to the return team for their blocks down the field. Although that was a shorter kickoff than normal, it still was great blocking and even a better run by Sony. So they paid for trying to keep it out of Zeke's hand that time.
Yeah, they did a great job of blocking. Boy, I wish I had the number of the kid, and I'll get it after this kick.
Extra point is up and good.
That's another great.
Oh, wait a minute. Did we miss it, Chris?
I believe we missed it. It was low snap. We had to get it up off the turf, and the timing was really bad. I think he pulled it left. Yeah.
It looked good.
Yeah.
But it wasn't.
That's a kinetic by Windstream scoring drives. Satterfield going 73 yards after the safety. They kick it off to a Satterfield, takes it 73 yards for the kinetic by Windstream scoring drive. Habersham on top, 22-6. Mark, I was going to say, Mark, in that return, somebody was making a block and decided at the last minute not to block them. Had they blocked them, it would have been a block in the back. They did the right thing, and Satterfield just ran right by the would-be tackler as well and turned it into big 6 points for Habersham.
Yeah, I saw that block you're talking about. I said, oh, no, don't do it. Don't do it. And he pulled up. Good coaching by our special teams coaches that time. He pulled up, and he had to. He kind of chested him there a little bit and slowed the guy down from behind. And the Sony cut off that block back to the inside and made the run to the sideline after that. So good play.
Actually, it was Sumdy. Sumdy,
okay.
Sumdy Satterfield.
Yeah, okay, Sumdy. Yeah. Sony's 85, okay.
Right, yeah.
Sumdy, okay, I got you. Yeah, great run, great blocking, just a good play and good coaching by our special team staff to get that ready and make that play. Because like you said, our offense has been struggling inside our half of the field. We needed that big break by our special teams.
Hill going to kick it off. Low, hard kick, and they get it inside the 10, about the 8-yard line to the 20. Oh, get jump on his back. He's still on his feet. Coming down the far side, we get him at the 40-yard line. Was that Gordon on the return?
Couldn't tell the number here, but, boy, another good kick by Hill, though. He drives it all the way down to the five and kicked it to the corner. I think that's what we want, trying to kick him to the corner. But with their athletic ability and good blocking, now they'll start this drive with 3:31 to go at the Habersham 40.
Javin Gordon on that return for Stevens County tackles made by Hayden Gailey. Hayden Gailey made the tackle for Habersham on that special team. First down and 10. And they're going to hand the ball off to Gordon again, right up the gut. Got across the 45 to about the 46, maybe.
You got to remember, Hill, just a freshman, a sophomore.
Right.
Started last year as a freshman. I think we might watch him before this year's over, and definitely the rest of his career. I think those kickoffs are going to sail into the end zone. I mean, those are going down to about the two or three. Each time his leg's just going to get stronger.
Second down and 4. They gave Gordon 6 yards on that last carry. They're at their own 46-yard line. Underwood in a shotgun. Hands it off to Gordon. He gets away. He was trapped in the backfield. Now he's loose. He's at the 40, 35 to the 30-yard line. Brought down there by the shoestrings by Sumby Sadafone.
Man, and how did he get out of that? We had such penetration in the backfield. He ran into one of our guys and bounced off of him and brought it back to the left side and found a nice hole and good hard running. They're down at the 30-yard line already.
That was a 24-yard run, Chris. What could have been a loss.
Yeah, I'm looked like a 5-yard loss.
They got 24 yards, 2:35 to go. Gordon's rushed 8 times for 46 yards here in this ball game. They're in a shotgun. Play clock is down to 12, or rather the play clock. And they're gonna run it. No, quarterback's gonna pull it. Underwood coming around his left side being chased, and he just runs right out of bounds and stops the clock with 2:13 to go. Underwood just ran right out of bounds. Closest man to him was Gailey.
Yeah, first time we've seen the running play by the quarterback. This is the option play.
They stopped the clock with 2:13 to go. 22-6, Chris.
Second one. Good game that time by Underwood.
They got a wide out to the right. Got two on the left. Gordon's your running back. Underwood takes a snap, hands it off to Gordon. He's got a good hole up the middle, and he'll score a touchdown.
We missed a tackle at the 15. Dove for his knees and didn't lock him up good, and he ran through it. And they answer, and they really felt like they needed to answer, and they did. And it started with the kickoff return, giving them good field position.
22-12. He'll come in for an extra point. Luke Waters will stick it up there. Trip Underwood, your holder. Snap, hold, kick is up, and it is good. Timeout of the field, 2:06 to go here in the half. Habersham leads 22-13. Commercial break. We'll be right back.
Field. Stevens County answers the Habersham touchdown with a scoring drive brought to you by Kinetic by Windstream. 4-play, 60-yard drive, 1:32. That's their running back. Davon Gordon gets his first score of the year, and Habersham leads 22-13.
Luke Waters is going to kick it off and pushes Whittington to about the 2, to the 10. Whittington to the 15, to the 20, and spun around at the 21-yard line. So Zeke Whittington on the return for Habersham.
1:59 to go. Ball at the 21-yard line. You don't take too many chances here, Mark, but you have two timeouts. And you know Coach Harrison really disappointed that his offense has got 14 points. And so it'd be interesting to see how he calls plays here.
Yeah, we scored, you know, the first two times they had the ball and everything looked good offensively. Give Stevens County credit. They stiffened their defense, especially up front on the run there. Made us try to throw the ball a little bit. This is what you work on the two-minute drive here right before half. The question is, it's on our own 21, so you can't get too greedy here. But let's see if our two-minute offense works.
Got an empty set. Parker's back there by himself and just going to run it right up the gut. And he'll get a yard or two, and that'll be about it. Parker just right up the gut.
Well, spread the field, just run it up the middle with your quarterback, and yeah, maybe you spring something, but you get 4 yards. You try to get one first down, and then you might think about using timeouts and working the sidelines.
Second down, second and six. They're on the 25-yard line, or on 25. Parker. Play action, wants to throw, looks, going to go long, and it's going to be incomplete. Pass intended for Zeke Whittington.
Threw that one threw a really good ball. Zeke's running a post pattern, skinny post down the middle, but they got free safety help deep, and that was just a tough throw. Looked like they might have a chance to intercept it, but also Zeke with a slight chance of making a catch. But now you're third and five. You don't want to have to punt this ball back to him, and you just stop the clock with that incomplete pass.
1:20 on the clock. Parker. I would imagine if they stop us, they'll immediately call time.
Yeah, they've got three left. I mean, you've got the run option pass here if you're Havisham, I think.
Five on the play clock, three on the play clock, two, one, and we're going to get a penalty. No, we don't. And we're going to try to run it. Parker gets loose, and he won't get close to a first down. Got to about the 30-yard line, and they call timeout. Timeout, 1:10 to go. Havisham Central leads at 22-13. Commercial break. We'll be right back. Stay with us. Yep.
Welcome back here to Raider Stadium, 22-13. Boy, second quarter has lasted forever. 1:10 to go. Havisham's going to have to punt it to Stevens County. Oh, we really needed a first down there, and we didn't get it.
Candom needs the young sophomore in there to kick it away. Snap is there and got away the kick end over end, and they're going to let it hit. And it's going to get a great roll for Havisham, but then they pick it up on the dead run, and that's Gordon. He'll dance out of bounds around the 43-yard line, 42-yard line.
Yeah, kick too short for him to come field it, but it got a good hop for us, but it also got a good hop for them as it went straight to him. And 1 minute exactly left in this quarter, in this half, and we lead 22-13, both teams with two timeouts.
So 1 minute, as Chris said, to go. We're up 22-13. Underwood's going to be your quarterback. He'll have Gordon in there.
Sondy,
in the backfield.
Yeah, Sondy Sadavon had to check out. Looked like maybe a cramp. Zeke's going to come in and play that cornerback position.
We'll play action. Oh, he's going to fall down. He pulled the ball and just slipped. And they lose about 8 yards.
Yeah, that's a running play as well. No timeout taken. They're burning a lot of clock here. Let's see what they do. All the way down to 38 seconds. They haven't even gotten up the line of scrimmage.
They got two timeouts.
Two timeouts. They're not taking them. Let's see what they do here. Got 30 seconds.
Got two to the right. Got a split left. And they're going to run the ball with Gordon. And Gordon, nothing.
Yeah. They're just going to take this one into the half. Seven timeouts in their pocket.
Yeah, that's kind of interesting.
Yeah, well, that play really hurt them, but they could still could have taken a timeout and stopped the clock.
All right, that's going to be the end of your first half. Haversham Central leads it 22-13. And there is the horn. Haversham leads it 22-13. We're at the half. Let's take a commercial break. When we come back, we'll have our halftime show. We'll talk with Lawrence Smith along with Chief Cunningham and Josh Tanner. We'll take a look around the area with what all is going on in this first week.
Thank you. Be sure to Thank you.
Other weapons, and he's done that at times, but we got to see. I want to see the offensive line take their take the momentum like they had early.
Early on, they were moving people. They were a great host for Carson and Hunter, and we had momentum. And then somewhere, either a defensive front line would change or something, Stevens' defensive front kind of took over. So we need to retake and re-own that offensive line that we had early and lost in the second quarter.
Yeah, I agree with you, no doubt about it. To bring us tonight's second half action. Both teams are out on the field. Evan Foster.
All right, Chris, thank you very much. 22-13. Now we're ready to start off the second half.
last two kickoff returns have been pretty positive. They got three for 99 yards there in that first half. We've got to do a better job of kick coverage here.
Michael Hill going to punch it up there and catch it around the 23 and then get to about the 26.
Yeah, we said the heck with that. We pooched it over here to the right corner. A little bit different strategy, and we executed that pretty well.
Devin Cobb was the young man that made that catch and got a couple of yards after the catch on the kickoff. So we're going to see the Stevens County offense here to start off the second half.
Big series for this Raider defense, even though 22-13 lead. I want to set the tone here defensively and get them three and out.
Direct snap to Gordon. Where's the quarterback?
Yeah.
Gordon takes a snap. Going to run to the right side and nothing. Maybe got back to the line of scrimmage. Wildcat there, Chris.
Yeah, Wildcat did not see that in the first half. And doesn't look like the quarterback. Unless he lined up at wide out that time.
I don't see him in there.
He didn't come in after the play.
They're going to give him about a half a yard on it.
Across the way,
He's not hurt, is he? There again, they're in that Wildcat, going to direct snap to Gordon.
Oh, he's standing right over there.
And the man in motion from left to right. They're in the white, we're in the blue, and Gordon going to try to find some room again. Not much. Maybe a yard, that'll be it. It's going to be third down.
From that backside linebacker position, it just crashes the backside hard and makes a tackle from the backside. Now Underwood's going to check in the ball game, third and long.
Out of the game goes Dawson Childs. So for some reason, they tried the Wildcat formation for those first two and didn't get a whole lot.
Yeah, not much going there, interesting.
Now they got Underwood back in there, and Gordon's a step behind him. Third down, third and eight. They want to throw, going to dump it out there. Little screen, they got some room to run to Gordon, and Gordon gets upended around the 42-yard line. He'll have the first down.
That's the second time that screen, middle screen, has been real effective, and it gets them a big first down.
Picked up 12 yards.
Linebackers just got to recognize that and pick up that running back.
Stevens to the line of scrimmage. They'll send two wideouts over here to the left. And now we got a timeout, official timeout.
Chains tangled up or messed up over there on that side.
Okay. Maverick Chitwood out. Back in the game comes Landon Savage. .10:03 to go here in the third quarter, just underway in the second half.
Not the down marker, it's the actual chain at the line of scrimmage that they seem to be having an issue with.
Now we're ready to go, I think. All right, they wind the clock. Stevens up the line, first and 10 for them. They're at their own 42-yard line, working right to left. They're in the white, we're in the blue. Average on the five front, gonna go to that right side of the line. Gordon gonna try to dive forward for about 2 or 3 yards. That'll be about it. Went from the 42 to about the 45. Actually, they spotted the 46. Second down and six. Stevens being very patient here to start off.
Yeah, they really are. Just like we're going to be methodical with this drive, not getting up the line of scrimmage in a hurry.
Second down, six. And they give it to Gordon again. Gordon's going to have the, well, he got upended at the midfield stripe. He fell forward about the 49. I think he'll be about a yard short. Needed to get to the 48.
Goodness, pretty nice spot there. I mean, that's almost
very generous spot.
Where you got to measure it, but he's about a little bit short. I think he landed right there, but it wouldn't matter. It's only maybe about a half a foot forward, but big play here, third down. See if we can get Hensley or somebody in the backfield. A tackle for loss here.
Third down, about a yard for a first. Underwood takes it and going to give it to Gordon. Gordon going to try to jump outside. He may have lost yards.
Oh, he did. He lost a half a yard. That's Carter Barrett that time. Now fourth and one. Will they punt it? Looks like they're going to punt it. I thought they might just say, we're going to get a yard on you right here, even though it's at midfield.
Luke Waters is in there to punt the ball away. Real quick, I want to say hello to Clay Fisher, listening to us in Franklin, North Carolina, or rather Franklin, Tennessee. Also want to say a big hello to Coach Arnold Meeks, unable to be here tonight. So I hope Coach Meeks is doing well, he and his wife. Punt formation for the Indians.
Fake.
Fake punt, and they're going to have the first down and get to about the 45-yard line.
You had a feeling it was coming. We defended it pretty well. They only needed to get a yard. They only, well, from where he caught it, he ran it about five or six, but they picked up just enough, maybe a couple of yards more than they needed to get the first down. I really was surprised they were going to punt that one.
So they got 3 yards on the play. First down and 10 now. They're at Habersham's 46-yard line. First and 10. Got a split right. That is Cobb. Got two on the left. Underwood takes it. Play action, wants to throw. A little pressure, and he scrambles to the far side. Going to throw on the run, going to be incomplete. Pass is well short.
And once again, pressure that time and really forced him out of the pocket and made him make a really tough throw. Right? Number one over there's cramping up for them again. That's their receiver.
Yeah, Smith. Fine wide out. Injury timeout, 7:42 to go. Let's take a break. Habersham leads 22-13. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
Great play by Landon to stay in bounds. He kind of did like a receiver with his knees and held up so he caught the ball before he fell on the ground. So great recovery there by Landon. And gives us the ball back because Stevens was driving right there.
Yeah, they were. Big two turnovers now for Stevens County. Two turnovers for the Raider defense.
Yeah, so Habersham got the ball after the fumble by Stevens County. We're going to run a quarterback, and he'll try to get some yards, and he looked like he was going to stumble forward for only maybe one or two, but he stumbled forward for about four or five.
Yeah, he did. Picked up really about 7 yards there, David. back to that option play. Pulled it out of Gunn's stomach and just followed him back up in the line of scrimmage there at right tackle.
Yeah, you're right. He got 7 yards on that carry. Second down and three. And we're going to hand it off to our running back, Hayes Gunn. And Hayes has got forward progress to about the 45. We didn't see much of Hayes in that second quarter.
No, we really didn't. He kind of didn't get the touches that he wanted or maybe he needs to get there. So get him a little bit involved. The offensive line's got to control that line of scrimmage. And by golly, he fought forward and got 3 yards, David, and got that first down.
So they moved the chains. You set it down for the Raiders. Clock is rolling. We're down to 6:48 to go here in the third quarter. Haversham still has that 22-13 lead. We've got the ball. We're working left to right. And we want to throw. Parker going to gun it to the near side. Going to be caught there by Barrett. Carter Barrett caught it, spun around, and went out of bounds. He's going to be short of a first down by about 2 yards. Got probably a solid 8 yards on it, I guess.
Just a nice, good throw. Had to throw it over a linebacker and then dropped it in there to Carter. And sometimes Carson wants to try to put too much on the ball. That time he made a nice, good, softer throw, and Carter with a nice 7 yard. Here we go.
Second down, second and three. They're at Stevens' 47-yard line on that right hash. There's a snap. Give it off to the running back, Hayes Gunn. He's going to take a couple of feet with him, but then they push him back. His forward progress might get him to about the 48, maybe the 48 and a half. It's going to bring up third down. Third down. Yes, Chris, virtually no gain on that play.
Yeah, that didn't give him any progress there. I thought he got at least a yard, but big play here. You want to keep this drive going.
Zeke Whittington will be on this right side along with tight end Keller Green. Got a split left, slot left. Running back is Gunn. Third down, going to get off the gun again. He'll have the first down and more. Right up the middle, and he'll get to about the – oh, he fumbled it. The ground, yeah, ground calls the fumble. Okay. Yeah. So they're going to be caught a break there, and they'll spot the ball right around the 36-yard line.
That definitely popped out as soon as his hit right hip hit the ground. Well, they blitzed, I think, off the corner or something, and we just ran right past it, really. Good blocking up front, though, from that big offensive line.
5:35 to go, 22-13. First down and 10, we're at Stevens' 37-yard line. Parker's in a shotgun. Got a new running back in there, isn't it? And yes, that is a new running back in there. Was that Antonio Cantrell?
Yeah, that's Cantrell.
All right. Cantrell got about 3 yards, maybe four.
He stuck it up in there, but maybe with a few more running attempts there, Cantrell might see that was open to his left. He plants his foot in the ground and jumps out to the left. He picks up some pretty good yardage there.
Got 3 yards on that one officially. Second down, second seven at Stevens' 34-yard line. Ball is right in the middle of the field.
He's a pretty good-sized kid himself, and he really comes off the ball hard.
I'm going to split Barrett out to the left. Cantrell still your running back. And we fake it till we want to throw, looking for Whittington. Whittington is going to be open. Touchdown! 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 Zeke Whittington. Oh, my. How about that for Haversham Central? 34 yards in the touchdown.
Man, what a beautiful throw. But I tell you what, Zeke Whittington, you want to know how to run routes. Watch this kid run routes. He knows how to run a route, Mark. And he just gave that shoulder head move to the outside and then just broke it off right in front of that cornerback, and just a perfect throw by Carson, but just a beautiful route.
That was that old Tavares King move.
Yeah.
Fake the corner route, but as he get the defensive back turn and then run the post, and what a great throw by Carson Parker, because the safety was coming, but he threw that ball on a dime, hit Zeke on stride, great route, great ball, and as a result, you get a big touchdown for us.
Michael Hill with the extra point, it is up, and it is good.
That scoring drive brought to you by Kinetic by Windstream. It's a big one for Haversham. 7 plays, 64 yards. Parker to Whittington. Extra point by Hill is good. Stretches the lead back out to 29-13. I think Coach Harrison, David, Mark's got to feel a sigh of relief as his offense put together a really good drive there.
Yeah, no doubt about it, Chris. Haversham Central needed that in a big way.
They really did. Carson Parker, if he had his struggles last year, which he'll admit he did, he looks really comfortable tonight throwing the football. 16 of 23, 181 yards, two touchdowns. Whittington, as he's probably going to do just about every time we take the field, seven catches, 90 yards, and leads us in receiving now. And tonight's game, obviously, with two touchdown catches. So big, big drive there by Haversham. After the turnover, you can't forget, defense created their second turnover of the ball game.
I believe Carter Barrett forced that fumble.
I think he did too. Yeah. He was pulling on that ball as Jordan was getting tackled, and as Mark described it, just a great play by, I think that was Savage, that was able to keep his knees inbound while he had the ball.
Michael Hill going to kick it off and gets his leg into it, and this was just punched up there. They catch it at the 28-yard line. Come to the near side and got about 2 yards. And the fumble, ball's on the ground.
Well, they'll say he was probably down too, wasn't he? Or maybe not.
Well, it went out of bounds. Lost a yard or two with it. That was Cobb on the catch.
Cobb saying, now y'all can quit pooch kicking that one over here to me, or I'm going to start calling fair catches. That's two pretty good licks he's taking back to back over here, having to field that pooch kick.
Down to 4:29 to go now, Chris. We just need to try to waste some clock. And I know it's in the third quarter, but.
Yeah. Well, you want to, offensively, if you get it back, you definitely want to take your time. But defensively, got to keep playing with that intensity. I would expect Stevens County to play with a little bit more quickness and intensity than they did that first drive.
Got a new running back in there. That's Brock Tankersley. Tankersley's in there as a running back, and he takes the handoff to him, and Underwood pulls it, going to roll to the right, throws it up there, and it's going to be just away from everybody, out of bounds.
Good pressure, just forced him way out of the pocket and deep, where he just threw it away.
The defense have really kept Stevens County from getting any kind of rhythm tonight.
Yeah, defense, that's good pressure there. Underwood's had to get out of that pocket the last few times on some pass attempts.
It's like Brock Tankers is going to stay in the ball game.
Yeah, Gordon on that fumble, well, David, he kind of
– Well, he's back in
limping.
There.
Yeah, he's kind of limping back over toward the sidelines, but he's back in.
Yeah, and Tankers is going to be a wideout instead of a back. We got three wideouts, two on the right. Tankersley's over there, got a split left. Gordon's your running back, and they give it to Gordon. Gordon's going to go right up the middle and get about 2 yards maybe. Close to the 35. Just shy of the 35. It's going to bring up third down.
Tackled by Barrett from that free safety position.
Third down and seven, Chris.
7 yards to go.
Well, these defensive backs, they see run, and they just take off up the field.
All right, so Stevens up the line, third and seven. Got two wideouts to right, got a split left, got a slot left. Running back is Gordon, and they move, play action. They want to throw. Underwood's got time to throw long. It's up there and caught by Smith. Smith made a nice catch. But we had a flag.
We're going to have a late hit maybe on Underwood hitting the quarterback, or is it?
I don't know. I could have
swore. Will it be holding?
I could have swore there was, movement there before they got the snap off.
I thought it looked like there was too. Boy, I tell you what, how good is Smith, the receiver? I mean, he can adjust to the football in the air. Made another kind of circus catch there. And
personal foul, rushing the pass.
Yeah, and Underwood's got a heck of an arm.
Imagine they'll wave it off and just take the play.
I don't like you, David. I thought somebody moved.
.3:32 to go in the third quarter, 29-13. Haversham leads. Stevens trying to threaten here. It's going to be a penalty after the play. So they mark it from where he landed to inside the 15, and they spot it down around the 12. So personal foul got it inside to about the 12.
Yeah, knocking on the door here to try to get it back to 29-20. They might go for two if they scored, but let's see if his defense can come up with a goal line stand.
And they give it to Gordon. Gordon right up the middle, going to try to bounce outside, and he tried to get loose, did just for a moment, though, but brought down shy of the five.
tough runner that Gordon is. He doesn't come down on the first hit.
Tackle was made by Braden Hensley.
Second down
for the Indians. Approaching the 3-minute mark here in the quarter. Stevens County up the line. They got a wide out to the right. Actually, they got two now out there. Cobb joined Swinton. And they want to give it off to Gordon. Gordon around that right side. He'll cut in for the touchdown. Gordon got in for the touchdown.
I'm going to go for two here.
Makes it 29-19.
No, they're going to kick it.
So into the ball game comes Luke Waters. They got Trip Underwoods, your holder now. There's this snap, the hold, the kick. It's up there and good. Time out of the field. 29-20 is your score, Chris.
Yeah. Kinetic by Windstream. Scoring drive there for Stevens County. 5 plays, 69 yards. It only took them a minute and 48 seconds. And that was their running back, Javon Gordon, scoring again. That's his second score of the night. Now he's got 19 carries, 105 yards. Habersham was still with a two-score lead, 29-20. 2:44 to go here in your third quarter. And a big play, though, Mark. Underwood finding that receiver, Smith, on a really good throw and catch.
Yeah,
kept that drive going.
Yeah, he kind of threw it up there a long time. He had a long time to throw it. And the time we got the pressure to him, it was too late. He got it off. And as a result, we ended up with a rough in the passer, which gave an extra 12 and a half yards because of half the distance to go from the 25. But that ball stayed in there a long time. And the receiver made a good adjustment to the ball. And guys, they came back to the ball and made the catch. So really two good plays by their receivers to adjust to a ball that was kind of thrown up there. But he got that ball out there, and then he took the lick as a result. But we got to do a little bit better job down here inside on the 25. We made it look easy with Gordon there on the easy run there. So a little bit more defense on the goal line defense would be good. But we got to answer with an offense is the key here. We've got to score on these next couple drives.
Luke Waters going to kick it off and going to be caught by Whittington at the 8 to the 10, 15, 20, up to about the 30-yard line. Nice return that time by Zeke Whittington.
Could have been a late hit there. I mean, he was lying on the ground. Somebody came in on top of him. No call, but good, tough running by Zeke. He doesn't shy away from any kind of contact. And he just kind of bounced off people from about the 25-yard line all the way up to 32.
Tackle was made by Omar Feaster. So Habersham's got to do something offensively here now. We're up by 9 with 2:36 to go here in the third quarter.
We got to keep the pressure on the Stevens County defense. If you're Habersham's offense.
Habersham's going to send Trips to the left. Barrett, Whittington, and Savage are out there on the left side. Got a tight end right. We're going to fake it, our quarterback. There he go. Oh, tripped up, man. It looked like he was off to the races, Chris.
Well, he really did.
Somebody got a hand on him, but Parker looked like he was going to go.
I couldn't tell which guy that was. Maybe the one getting up limping a little bit.
Second down, got a solid 8 yards on the carry.
Carson, 10 carries, 63 yards prior to that run.
You say Santana Smith made a tackle on Parker. Or check it, they're gonna change it to Swinton. Second down, second and 3 officially from the 39. We're gonna run with it, and we'll be short of a first down, got to the 40.
Oh, yeah, Guns, look at him.
He's yeah, he makes forward progress.
Yeah, he just kept the feet and legs driving.
Man, it looked like he had nowhere to go.
It did, didn't it? And it bounced out of that pile and picked it up by 2 yards.
So they gave him the first. You set it down to the Raiders. 1:45 to go here in the third quarter. 1:38, clock's moving. We're up 29-20. First and 10. Habersham on that right hash, moving left to right, away from the scoreboard. Parker looking the other way, away from our bench. Hands it off to our running back, and he'll get to the 45-yard line. tackle made by one of those linemen, Jacob Lunsford, the junior nose guard.
He came in from the backside that time. We must have missed a block. Only a pickup of two there.
Down to 102 to play in the third quarter. Haversham going to use as much time as they can, I guess.
Yeah, might as well. You take this all the way down to the fourth quarter here with this play.
Second down, eight. We're at our own 45-yard line, that right hash. Parker's got it. Hands it off. Right up the gut. There he goes. And Hayes Gunn going to have a first down. He got across the 45, down to about the 40. Got a flag back to the line of scrimmage.
Wow, you're going to get a holding call that quick? It's got to be what it's going to be. Tough break here. You got a really good run that time.
Block below
block
the waist.
Below the waist, okay. Ah. That's a tough break. Get it all the way down to the 40 on a good run, and now the penalties marker. They're really hurting this offense. Seven penalties for 74 yards prior to that one.
Man, now it's second down and 23. And we were first and 10 at the 40. Talk about a turnaround.
That's significant.
We want to throw. Parker's forced out of the pocket. And then you want to throw on the run. Going to be caught around the 41-yard line. Who made that catch, Chris? Whittington.
Yeah. Zeke Whittington. Carter Barrett down there. He ran a go route, and no way Carson could see him. But he was wide open, but his left calf is cramping up big time on him.
And that's going to be the end of the third quarter. That's the end of three quarters. Haversham leads by 9, 29-20. Commercial break. Don't go anywhere. We'll have the fourth and final period here on My Country 99.3. Stay with us. We'll be right back. Haversham's got trips to the left, got a split right. Everett Rudisill's over there on the right. We got five wide, yeah. Chris. We got another one out there.
Zeke split out wide to the right. Yeah, we're going five wides. We'll see how they match up. And going to give that man-to-man coverage, I think Coach Harris has been wanting to see against Zeke. Who's that guarding him over there? Smith, the standout wide out. The wide receiver going to guard Zeke.
Parker's got it, looks that way. Gonna throw it up there, looking, overthrown. Zeke cut in and.
Yeah, Zeke ran a little hitch route at the yard line, at the first down line, but you know, about the 45, and Carson threw a go route. A little miscommunication there. Boy, he had Zeke open too, because Smith was expecting go route. Zeke broke that route off. And, to Stevens County, leading 29-20. Well, the penalty kills us again, guys.
Camden Meade's going to kick the ball away.
I know Clayton's right, but Stevens County only been penalized two times for 7 yards. Haversham, 8 for 89.
Meade has got it and got away the kick. Pretty good kick for the youngster. And Gordon calls for a fair catch around the 27-yard line. He's come in and done a good
job.
Yeah,
he's doing a good job. I mean, gets a good kick. Kind of makes a move to catch it. I mean, decent hang time. And, that time he had a little pressure on him as well.
All right, defense, Chris. We got to get them to.
Yeah, we got to. Can't give up a big play here. Leading 29-20.
A lot of time left.
A ton of time left. You'd like Haversham to get the ball back and just run out a bunch of clock.
All right, first and 10 for the Indians. Underwood's in there, Gordon's in there, and Smith is in there, that fine receiver over here, being guarded by Sumdy, Satterfield. They'll run the ball with Gordon. Gordon's gonna fall forward for about 5 yards. It'll be second down. Put it right on the 34. 11:29 to go in the game.
I mean, Gordon is their running game. 20 carries. Closest one to him is the quarterback, Tripp Underwood, with two.
Second down, second 5. Stevens at their own 34. There's a snap. Give it to Gordon, and Gordon going to be, boy, gets loose for a first down and gets up to midfield. Looked like he was going to be brought down. Shy of the first down, but got loose and then got to the midfield stride.
Yeah, he's a good sized kid, but we got to do a better job of tackling him. We're hitting him early, but not bringing him down. But give him credit, he's running through those tackles.
He got 15 yards in the first down. Got down to the Stevens 49-yard line, just shy of midfield. Gonna split two out to the left. Smith is out there, along with Brock Tankersley. Got two on the right now. Gordon's out here as a wide out on the right side. Now we got a timeout by Stevens. Timeout, 10:41 to go. Haversham leads 29-20. Commercial break. We'll be right back.
Spread us out now. Better get this matchup right here.
First down and 10. Stevens has the ball. They want to throw. They pump it. Now they want to throw long, and it's going to go long, looking for Smith, and he's got a flag. Got a flag down there around the 10-yard line. I guess it's going to be pass interference on us.
Yeah, we were running with him, and they slowed down because it was underthrown, and as we did, we ran into him, and we're looking right at the receiver, not turning back to find the football. You'll get a penalty on that one every time, but it's not a spot of the foul like NFL, so they'll mark it off from the line of scrimmage.
15-yarder, though.
We'll move it down to 35, 36.
10:34 to go here in your ball game. First down, 10. Underwood in a shotgun. Gives it off to Gordon. Gordon coming around the near side. Gordon broke a tackle. Then he got hit around the 30 or the 29. Got away from one, and the second man got him.
Piddle.
Finally one on them.
I believe we're going to get one go against them here, maybe. We'll see if it's a block in the back or a holding. It's at the line of scrimmage. Could be a block below the waist.
Well, you can say we're getting home cooking. Block, yeah, block below the waist.
Yeah.
10:25 to go. Still got a 9-point lead. It'd be nice somebody to get the defense to make a play, wouldn't it?
Yeah, we've gotten two turnovers, created both of them. Let's see if we maybe can come up with another one.
They mark it back into Raider territory, or rather into Indian territory. First down and long, about 25. And they play action. They want to throw. Underwood going to go long, looking for Smith, I believe, and it's going to be incomplete. Now, I'll tell you what. They want another defensive interference.
Well, I mean, he's just running with him, and the ball's 4 yards out of bounds, Mark. Kind of difficult for a referee to say that's pass interference there, but, boy, it's not going to keep Coach Tankersley from asking for it.
Yeah, we got a penalty for our coach running out to the referee, and he's out there all over him, ran out on the field, no call. And it was an iffy call. It could have easily been pass interference. He's got a beat, but he can't run out on the field. Right in the referee's face.
And getting out of the coach's box.
We got one. He was all the way down at the 20-yard line where he met him, and we got a big 15-yard penalty on this for the same thing. But it could have gone either way, but the big thing is sets up second 25.
Yeah, I mean, the ball was uncatchable. It was landed on the other side of the white line on the out-of-bounds sideline. So
he's got a timeout. 10-10 on the clock. The penalty against Stevens. What happened here?
Illegal substitution.
Oh.
Back him up five more, so now second and 30. They're going to spread us out. Although they're having good success running the football. Plenty of time, but they seem like they want to try to spread us out now and just challenge our cornerbacks, and we put them on an island a good bit.
Smith is going to go left, Chris, along with Tankersley. So look for something on that side. Smith is that fine receiver. Underwood hands it off to Gordon, and he's hit in the backfield and knocked down for a loss.
There we go, Cantrell.
Yeah, big play that time by our linebacker, Antonio Cantrell, the 6'1", 210 junior.
Yeah, big play. Good-looking football player in that uniform. Put together pretty well. Good tackle for a loss there. But 31.
32.
I think
get it right, Chris.
I think they challenged us with Smith. I shade Gailey over right here from that free safety position. Help out.
Third and long. Play action. They want to throw. They're looking that way. Time over the middle. Going to be caught and hit immediately. Well short of the first down. It'll be fourth down and long.
They got probably 14, 15 yards there. Penalties really hurt them, just like they've hurt Habersham.
Satterfield made the tackle. So now it's going to be fourth and 20. After that 12-yard pass play to Smith. And they're in punt formation. Luke Waters is there. We got Zeke Whittington back deep. So he's by himself. They have one fake punt, but not this time. Good punt, and Whittington lets it go over his head. Roll, but it's going to get a good Raider roll. How about that?
Yeah, boy, he had him deked a little bit, or a lot. Ball was over here on the left hash. He's on the right hash looking up like he's going to catch it. And it had kicked toward the Raider bench and backwards. So worked out pretty good.
8:38 to go.
Flag on the field?
Or it's a timeout.
It's timeout.
No, Harrison's coming on the field.
Give it more. They're gonna just give us a little extra time here, I guess, for water. Yeah. Hey, Mark. Come down to you.
What's that?
Give us a little extra time, I guess, for water.
Yeah, it's a water break because of heat when it's this humid and this. Of course, it's not very hot. Actually, there's a little bit of a breeze down. It's pretty comfortable, but it's first game of the year. There's a lot of humidity in the air. There's been some cramps already, so the referees are just doing this to make sure the players are safe, got hydrated, give a little extra minute to breathe. No timeout by either team. Just an official timeout for water break. Big series here by offense. We got 838. Boy, if we could get – do we have an 838 drive in us? Because that's what the doctor ordered right here is just use the clock and drive this thing down the field. And to use much clock because we are still up by two scores, 29-20. So that's a two-score difference. So if we can just churn out a lot of clock and burn this thing out and make Stevens County have to get into some kind of high-speed offense, which I don't think they like, that would be to our advantage. So we got to use some clock here.
Starts up front with that big line.
All right. Parker is your quarterback, of course. And is that Hayes gun in there? We put Savage in motion. And we'll give it off to Hayes. And he's driving those legs, driving those legs, driving, 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 baby. Yeah.
Still not down.
How about that, Chris?
That's good, strong running right there. And then he got a little push from some of his linemen as they got in behind him, and he just kept carrying that pile for a first down.
He probably had about 400 pounds on his back.
He did. I'd like to know what his squat is because he's got some huge thighs, and I guarantee he's really one of the stronger guys in the weight room.
He needed 10, got 12. And he's got that clock rolling. We're down to 8:10 to go in your ball game. We're up by 9.
Now he's our leading rusher, 13 carries, 72 yards.
First down and 10. We got Savage in motion. He comes set on the right side. And there goes Hayes Gunn again. Got upended around the 40, though. But again, another 7 yards maybe. 6 or 7 possibly. Let's see where they spot it.
Two plays in a row where there's been a nice hole for Hayes to run through. Good job up front.
Second down. That offensive line's played well tonight, Chris.
They really have.
Whittington right, got a split left, got a slot left. Got Savage in motion from that slot. We're going to run Hayes Gunn, and this, yeah, he's going to get, well, got maybe a yard. He tried to jump out of there, but couldn't. It's going to be third down, 7-11 to go.
Got to find a way to get 3 yards here. You don't have to get all the way up to the 44-yard line, just short of it.
Third down, about 2.5 yards to go for the Raiders.
Getting the call from the sideline. 23 seconds on the play clock, so no rush.
Third down.
Cliff Carson keeps it on the little option play.
Third down and 3. We're at our own 41-yard line. Got Savage in motion. And, yeah, Parker's going to keep it. He'll have the first down as he got across the 45 to about the 46, 47-yard line. Good call, Chris.
Yeah, you felt it coming. And, boy, Carson pulled it out of Gunn's stomach and was just – flying up through the line of scrimmage. Good blocking again. And nice first down there to keep the chains moving and, more importantly, keep that clock moving. 6:25 to go. Won't end up snapping this one until there's probably about 6 minutes to go in the game.
First down and 10 at our own 47-yard line. Just shy of midfield. There's a snap. Handoff to Cantrell. Cantrell's going to get hit right the line and push backwards. Probably no gain on the play. Tell you what, Chris, one of the All-State good hands player of the game could be one of these offensive linemen.
Yeah, could be. A big line, isn't it, David? I mean, it's some size we haven't seen all the way across the board at every position. 17 seconds on the play clock. We're really burning as much as we can here.
12, 11, 10.
Gotta hurry up now, though.
8, 7, 6. Parker's got him set. Fourth. And we get the play off to Cantrell. Cantrell's going to try to jump outside. And he's going to go down the far side. He's down the good, about the 25. Oh, checking 30 to the 30. Yeah, got about 25 maybe, Chris.
Yeah, boy, we milked every second off the play clock, and then Cantrell with hard running bounced to the outside and broke away from people in a nice game. His best one of the night.
Good run that time by Antonio Cantrell, the junior. First and 10. He got 20 yards on that carry.
Yeah, very, very good run. That takes a life out of a defense, too. You Let's get a big run for a first down and move the chains.
First down and 10. Got Savage in motion from left to right. Oh, he dropped the ball. Get on it, Parker.
Ah, boy. He just took his eye.
Who recovered it, Parker?
No, it was one of our running backs.
Hayes Gunn got it.
Yeah, Gunn.
Golly.
Parker just kind of took his eyes off of that one. A big 10-yard loss, too. One of the bad things about it as well, you recovered it.
Well, the clock is still running. Second down and long.
He may have been motioning over sidelines. That football was wet. With all the sweat on it or something. We got a new one in there.
4:30 to go in the game, 9 on the play clock. Parker has two to the right, got Savage in motion. 3 seconds, 2 seconds to get it off. Play action, going to gun it, going to be incomplete. Pass intended there for the wideout. Let's see, that was
Wilson.
Yeah, Jonah Wilson.
Good play by the defensive back. He got his right arm in there and knocked that one away. Stops the clock. It's the only bad thing there, but you just about had to throw it there. Second long, now it's third and long. And you may seek to keep the ball on the ground here, running it, and then run it again on fourth down.
All right. Third and 18. Savage in motion. And we're going to fake it and want to throw. Looking. Got a flag. Going to throw it long, and it's going to be incomplete.
Probably a holding call.
Good pass was intended for Zeke Whittington. Yeah, we got a flag back at the line of scrimmage.
They'll probably decline it.
Yeah.
They want to give us another down. Ah. Mark, I still like the run call there on third and forever just because the clock is in your favor there.
Yeah, you ran some time out there. We started this drive 8:38, and we got it down to 4:10. We could have run 40 seconds off. I agree with you in a way. I know Coach Harrison wants to try to get some big yards there. He was trying to hit maybe not the whole yard of 20 yards. He was trying to get about a 10-yard route, but they covered it well. And then when Carson got a flush, he had to throw it, try to throw it deep to Zeke. So, yeah, running play would have knocked 40 seconds off, but that's just not Coach Harrison's way sometimes. He had a good play, I think. But they sniffed it out, stopped the sticks play, and as a result, we got to punt it with 4:10 left. Still up by two scores, though.
Yeah.
Camden Meade's in there to punt the ball away.
Angle this one toward the sidelines, I would assume.
He's got it. Oh, he dropped it. He dropped it, and he's going to get hammered.
Well, the pressure of being back there for the first time on a big punt, he just took his eyes off of it. Tough break. You don't expect or think about that happening, but it could, and maybe that's another good reason why you just run that thing on third and long and just keep the clock going. It just keeps that clock going even if you don't get the 4 yards. Tough break by the sophomore. If his defense can bow up now, 45-yard line, as Mark said, though, we're up by 9. No matter what they do, a score can't tie it up.
4:04 to go. They want to throw. Underwood looking. Going to go long and incomplete.
I don't really know. I mean, Tankersley's been in that guy's ear the entire game. And that's a pretty late flag. No, that's just a tough position. That's a tough play to call as a referee. Ball's underthrown. I guess, Martin, the only thing there is we're face guarding him. But
that came from the side judge.
Yeah.
He's on the line of scrimmage.
Yeah.
And that ball was 20, 30 yards down the field. And he threw that flag however far, 30 yards down the field from the sideline. So you know that had to come from the head coach because the guy on the spot, the back judge, no call.
That's his call.
And the side judge on the line of scrimmage is the one that threw the flag 25 yards down the field and came running down there. And it was a late flag on top of that.
Yeah,
it was about 3 seconds after the play ended. So I'm just wondering who got an earful there.
Yep, Coach Harrison, I think, going to take a timeout and settle his guys down.
Timeout on the field, 3:58 to go. Haversham leads by 9. Commercial break. We'll be right back. Damn. We can't make it easy. They went for the end zone, and it's going to be intercepted by Hayden Gailey. Hayden Gailey got the huge interception for Haversham Central with 3:50 to go here in your ballgame. How about that? They're trying to get Smith on a little post there, Chris. And how about that for Hayden Gailey?
Exactly right. They were looking Smith all the way. Smith ran the post from the left side. Gailey recognizes it, leaves his position to come over from the right side hash mark and make a great interception. And just a tremendous play, Mark. Just, I mean, he read the quarterback, knew he was probably going to Smith, and he just made a good play on the ball, made a heck of an interception.
Well, his granddad is Chan Gailey, a famous NFL head coach and a coordinator. So you could tell he was a coach on the field right there. That was a perfectly thrown ball, by the way. Smith was going to catch that in stride in the back of the end zone. And Hayden saw it and read it. And came, like you said, Chris, came from the opposite hash and cut in front and made a great play.
Tremendous play.
Parker going to hand the ball off to Hayes Gunn. We just need to run it. Keep that clock running. They're going to call time. Timeout, 3:44 to go. We're up by 9, 29-20. And a commercial break. We'll be right back.
And they've got.
All right, back at Raider Stadium, second down and 10. And legal procedure?
Yeah, I'm not sure. We had confusion up there for some reason. And it was coming out of a timeout. Timeout from Stevens County.
5 yards against the Raiders. How many is that now, Chris?
Way more than Coach Harrison's going to be happy about, 11 of them for 124 yards.
Wow. Second down and 15 now. And now another one. Legal procedure on us again.
It's hard to tell, Mark. Who's that being called on? Somebody on the far side of the field, obviously.
The first one was our slot back, and it was a Bart call, so there's no play. And he still jumped anyway, so Coach Harris was very upset. That time we had a play call, and the defensive line, they've been doing it all night, they're stemming up front. They're moving up front right before the snap, and one of our linemen flinched on that one.
Got a man in motion. We toss it to him. That's off Whittington in it. Coming to the near side, and he cuts up to across the 15.
Good
to
job.
About the 17.
Good job by Zeke, though. Don't try to stretch it around to the edge and get knocked out of bounds. He was smart. And stayed in bounds, keep that clock running. They have one timeout, Stevens County does, but they'll obviously not take it here with a third and long.
And now they call timeout again.
Yeah, they did take their final timeout.
Third down and 13. Let's keep it right here, guys.
Left a little time running there before they took that final timeout, Mark. That's a little bit different.
They're trying to get as much time as they can because they know they got to get the ball back quick. And even at third and long, they need that time. So now they're out of timeout, so we're going to run the ball here. I would think, I'm not sure what Coach Harrison sometimes, try to use that 40-second clock with 3:20 left. That'd get it down to pretty close to 2.5 minutes, and then we'd have to punt. We'll have to see. He may do a pass here. He may not. I don't know. He's very upset with Carson because that's not the play he wanted. We got some yardage out of it. We'll see. So, interesting time out there. You're right, Chris, but they're right now feel like they need all the time they can get.
Yeah. So that was not the play he wanted there.
No, it wasn't. He was wanting, I think, a fake, and for Carson to follow Hayes up into the line of scrimmage, he wanted to use Carson, but he gave him the ball instead. And I don't know, it worked pretty good, but evidently that's not what he wanted. He was getting a pretty good earful, but it's first game, things like that'll happen.
I got a feeling Carson might be the designated runner on this play.
All right, third down, third and 13 from the 17, our own 17. And we put Whittington in motion and then hand it off to him around that right side. He's trying to find some running room, and he got up to about the 21-yard line.
Well,
so it's be fourth down.
Yeah, they can't stop the clock, 40 seconds. Snap this punt about 2.5 minutes to go in the game. Got to tell Means, just get the ball. Don't worry about how well you kick it. Just catch it and get it off. We'll probably let it run all the way down and take a timeout.
2:44, 2:43, 15 on the play clock. Haversham trying to win the season opener. Right now we're up 29-20. Stevens has no timeouts left. Is that right, Chris?
Yeah, they're out.
Yep. All right, there's a timeout by Haversham. Timeout by the Raiders. 2:26 to go. Haversham up 29-20. A little chess game going on.
Yeah. You got it. Obviously, you're punting the football here. Just need a good snap.
Going to bring in.
We don't have a punter. We don't have Means going back there.
Going to have to put a Hayden Gailey back there.
Hayden Gailey back there to punt it. I guess you just feel in this situation, put a senior back there and just tell him you catch it and you just punt any kind of punt you can get off.
I thought Michael Hill might have been the guy to come in if it wasn't going to be Mees. So Hayden Gailey back there at the 10-yard line. Snap is a little high, but he got away the kick, end over end, low kick, and they got it at midfield and to the 45 and still on his feet to about the 40 to the 38, maybe.
2:15 to go, still have a two-score lead. Can't give up a quick score here if you're Haversham on defense.
All right, so first down and 10. First down and 10. We're still showing Stevens with one timeout.
Got zero on the board over there. They called one early in the third quarter.
And they want to throw and a gun over there to the far side. They catch it and forced out of bounds.
Incomplete.
No catch?
Yeah, I see the ball lying on the sideline.
Okay.
They dropped it. Stop the clock.
Satterfield on the coverage over there. Second down and 10. 2:10 to go in the game. Stay tuned for scoreboard. Trent Demore and Josh Tamp. Braves won earlier today. Second down and 10. They want to throw, looking down the field, going to go to the near side, incomplete. short hop to intend to receiver. That was Dawson Childs. It's going to be third down now. 2:05 to go.
On rush three, drop back eight. Gonna make it a little difficult for Underwood to find somebody wide open, but gonna give him some time to throw it as well.
Let's see where, let's watch Smith, where he see where he goes, Chris.
Yeah, he's the key. I mean, I would expect a post pattern from him. He's gonna go wide left.
Yep. He's by himself over there on that left side.
Yaley gonna have an eye on him as well, even though he's lined up over here on the left hash.
And Underwood looks, forced out of the pocket, got a flag, and he's going to get run out of bounds around the 30-yard line.
At the line of scrimmage, likely a hold.
1:58 to go in the game. Haversham leads 29-20, hanging on. It's been a good crowd, Chris. They've seen a good ball game. Personal foul on us.
On us? Oh, do I have a hands to the helmet or something? Hands to the face?
Wow. Personal foul on us.
My goodness. That's going to be 13 penalties now. They just keep marking them off against Haversham. We only rushed three. I mean, it doesn't take one to make the penalty, but. Boy, Coach Harrison fit to be tied down there.
So they mark it off all the way inside the 20 to about the 11-yard line. First and 10. Tripp Underwood, the junior quarterback, has it, looks to throw, looks, has time to throw into the end zone, high and incomplete. Intended for Gordon.
We had everybody covered up really well. Good coverage that time. You know he's going to look Smith this time.
He's over here on the right now. Down to 1:52. Let's see, this is going to be second down and 10 there. Haversham 16-yard line. Fifth play of the drive. Working from that left hash. And quarterback has it. Looking to the end zone. Got a man and touchdown.
Smith, yeah. One-on-one over there. Sadafon just battling him the best he can. They kind of got his back turned to the ball, and Smith made the adjustment. And they scored. Going to be 29-26. And they probably – you got to kick the extra point here, don't you?
Well, they make it 27. That means the field goal could win it.
Yeah, I mean, because if you don't get the two-point conversion here and you get a chance with the onside kick –
Field goal
can only tie it.
Yeah.
They're going to go for two.
All right, going for two here. For the conversion. They've got it. They're going to throw it. Going to go. Two-point play is good. Went to Smith again. Yeah. Why not?
Pretty good little grub pick play over there to get Smith released back to the inside. He was wide open, 29-28, 1:46 to go. Your play of the game's coming up here. Boy, the personal foul, Mark. Did you ever go down to Mark real quick? I guess it was a hands to the face or something with us only rushing three.
Like I said, I was looking downfield for the coverage, and I looked back and saw the penalty and said, well, good, that's holding. So I kind of didn't pay attention to it, and then all of a sudden, Stevens County starts yelling. I go, wait a minute, what are you talking about? And it was like, I guess, a hand to the face that I didn't see. So that was a big, big penalty because that was a third down and long, and that all of a sudden gave him a big first down. And now they got the score. Not onside kick quad right here. We got our hands unit up close, and it's a big, you know, they practice this. We work on our hands unit just like they work on their onside kick. So big onside kick, and then if we get the ball like we're supposed to, then we still got to hold on to it for a minute 46. The good news is Stevens is out of timeouts.
Yeah.
So if we can get this onside kick, we can run a lot of time off that just running the ball three times. Big play right here.
Got to go 10 yards before they can touch it.
He's right on the 40-yard line.
He's almost offside.
Yeah. There it is. Get on it, guys. Get on it. Oh, gosh. Oh, my gosh.
Well, we didn't attack it. We let it play us, and we got to go get it. It was kicked perfectly because it was one of those that took that second hop and went straight up in the air. And we didn't go attack that onside kick like we needed to, and that allowed them to recover. We're going to ask this defense to come up somehow or another with a big play. Got it at the 49 of Stevens County. You know who they're going to look at.
One.
That's number one, Smith.
All right, let's go, guys. Let's go.
Can't really play prevent defense here. You got to come get them.
They're going to gun it. Going to be caught, and they hit the ground immediately. Catch was made there by Brock Tankersley. Clock is running. 134, 135, 134, 133. Second down, and about five. They're in Raider territory. Oh, they dropped the snap. It's on the ground. They get on it. About a 10-yard loss.
And it can't stop the clock either. They got to hustle up. He took his eyes off the snap that time.
115, 113, 111.
They're rotating defensive linemen, trying to get some fresh guys in there. They're trying to keep putting pressure on Underwood, make him uncomfortable in the pocket.
Smith is out left. 1 minute to go. Underwood wants to throw. Going to go long, and it's going to be caught, and they get loose to about the 45-yard line. 52, 51, 50, 49, 48.
Not enough for the first down. Fourth down and five. Here is your ball game. You got to keep them from getting the first down right here.
Fourth down and four. 37 seconds to go. They want to
procedure.
Throw, and they catch it for a first down.
That was a procedure call. The dude that called it backed up on the line of scrimmage when the ball was snapped. No call. Coach Harrison's going to lose his mind.
Now they got an injured player.
He clearly moved. And the referee looking right at it blew it. Just plain as day.
Injury timeout. 32 seconds to go. They're at
wow. The
39. Is that where it is? Or the 40?
40-yard line.
40.
I don't know how he missed it. I mean, Tankersley, the one that caught it, took a step back after he got set, and the ball was snapped. That's an obvious illegal procedure call, Mark, that they just missed.
And it's right in front of him, too. You're right. Yeah, I mean, the side judge can see that clearly. He has no receiver in front of him because the receiver was off the ball. And then when he stepped back, if anything, that gave him not enough people on the line of scrimmage. But he was moving when the ball was snapped. And then he did a good job holding on that ball. He took the punishment. He's the one down. We got a good lick on him, but give him credit. He held on that ball. It was just a five-yard route. He only needed 3 yards. He got five. Big first down for him. Only 32 seconds left, though, and they have no timeouts, and they got to go 40 yards. And we got to do something to keep them from getting even at least the field goal.
All right, first down. They're at Haversham's 40-yard line. Oh, they move again. They move all over the place.
Well, they got this one. That one would be pretty hard not to get. They're going to call this on Haversham? They are letting Tankersley talk way too much to the officials. He's out on the field talking to that same guy. This has got to go against Stevens County.
No call?
What just happened?
No call.
Yeah, I don't know.
Clock's running. Underwood looks. Gonna throw it out there. Got it to Gordon. Gordon gonna go down the far side. Gets
he's
out of bounds.
I thought he was out of bounds.
21 seconds.
Thought he got tackled inbounds. I don't know what happened there. There was movement. They jumped off sides. Two or three people did. There was no penalty.
21 seconds to go. One. Smith is out left. They got two on the right. Underwood has it. Looks to throw. Dump it out there to Gordon again. Gordon will get out of bounds.
They're in field goal range now. The 25, you got to pick up Gordon out of the backfield. That's all you got to do. 16 seconds left. You really don't have time to take a shot into the end zone. There's really no reason for it, but you Also going to send the kicker out there to win it for you late in the game. Ball spotted at the 28-yard line. Got to pick up Gordon out of the backfield.
Gordon is a running back.
Remember, they can't stop the clock.
They want to throw. They want to throw. Rolling to the far side. Going to dump it out there. It's going to be incomplete.
Oh, no. Then they're going to get us for a personal foul. Late hit on Underwood.
Two more flags thrown in there.
We got a flag here, flag over there. We have an ineligible man downfield possibly as well.
Good
God. They were holding, he held the ball for a really long time. I don't even know, Mark. I mean, it's a personal foul for sure.
There's three penalties. I think there's three different penalties. There's a early flag flown before the late hit on the quarterback. I don't know if it's legal man downfield or holding. And then it looks like, I don't know, I'm speculating, but looks like they called a late hit on the quarterback. And then another flag came late from the back judge on something that somebody said late or something, I don't know. So there's at least three different penalties on this play, and I'm not sure, I can't tell you what any of them are, maybe other than the late hit of the quarterback.
I know one thing.
And Tankley's out there.
He's right there in the middle of them. It's unreal.
He's standing there with the official.
Yeah, he's still yelling at him. They sort this out. There's more than one penalty.
He must not be happy.
Now there's 10 seconds left to set it straight. There's 10 seconds left. He was tackled. It was an incomplete pass, but the ball's on the 28-yard line of Habersham. So they're not, I'm thinking, field goal range.
Yes.
10 seconds left, but the penalty's going to be the key.
Yeah, the referee looks like he's getting ready to step this off against Stevens, Mark.
Well,
way he's,
what they do sometimes, they'll step one off one way and then step it off the other way. So we'll see. But Tankerness, he is getting a mouthful in, and we're not getting anything in. So I don't know. But this is going to be curious to see. They'll probably step the first penalty off, then step the second penalty off, and I'm not sure about the third one, what that late flag was. We'll have to see.
Could have been the personal foul call and just late getting it out of his.
Let me see if I can hear. Hold on. I'm going to see. He's going to come to talk to Coach Harris. Let me see if I can sneak this in.
Oh, my goodness. Well, they still haven't marked anything off. 10 seconds on the clock. We lead by one.
Now they look like they're going to mark it off against Haverkamp. They got their kicker out there.
Luke Waters is out there. So is the quarterback.
Yeah, I got it. All right, we got a holding penalty on them. But then there's a roughing the passer on them, and then the unsportsman is going to be the bad one on us. It was at the plate, so they're going to get a 15-yard penalty here because they said we use bad language in front of the referee. So they're going to get – the first two are going to offset because they're live. So they're going to get a 15-yard penalty here because it was a dead ball foul. So the first two offset, the holding penalty and the roughing the passer offset. But the unsportsmanlike conduct penalty, the 15-yarder – counts because it was a dead ball foul.
Yeah.
So that gets them now setting up for a field goal with 10 seconds left. It's going to be a 31-yard attempt from the left hash, and they're going to pull it off for the win right now.
All right. Luke Waters for the win. Now they come in. Harrison may have called time. We called time. 31-yard field goal. Golly, Chris.
Well, the distance is no issue. It's just whether they get the snap down and the hold correctly, and he boots it solidly. A lot of pressure, though. What year is he?
He's a sophomore.
Probably the first time he's had this experience.
So they're going to set it down at the 31-yard line. It's going to be a, or rather the 21. It's going to be a 31-yard field goal. All right, Luke Waters. Here we go.
The lefty kicking from the left hash.
And snap. Hold. It's Pitt. And it's golly.
It's good. Right through the uprights.
Looked like somebody got a hand on it.
I got it up there pretty easily. A little bit of a low snap, but they were able to get it on the tee, and he stuck it right up in there.
So they're up 31-29 with 5 seconds to go.
Well, that squib kicked this one.
Wow. 31-29. 5 seconds to go.
Yeah, they're just going to kick this one down the middle of the field. I'm not sure. You just probably try to down it as soon as you catch it. At least leave yourself a chance for one play and a miracle.
And Whittington is going to try to keep the ball alive. We've thrown it a couple times. Of course, we got a flag out there. Hayden Gailey trying to run down the near side. And he throws it back, and the ball is on the ground. That'll be it. We tried a couple of laterals, but we got a flag on the play.
I didn't think any one of them was an illegal forward pass.
We got a flag on the play. I'm sure it's on us, Chris.
I didn't see the illegal forward pass, though, Mark. I think all of them were laterals.
Okay, I think it looks like more they're going to call a horse collar on Zeke. He got pulled down from behind by his jersey around the neckline. I don't think it was anything by legal lateral. Everything looked backwards. But it looked like to me the way they tackled Zeke is right where he threw the flag. So it's going to be an untimed down, if that's what it is, because they're talking a long time. It's pretty easy to call horse collar or not, so I'm not sure what the discussion is. If it is a horse collar, it'd be a 15-yard from the 24, so it'd be about the 39-yard line, and then we'd have one untimed down. But I'm not sure what the long discussion is. I don't see another flag anywhere.
I don't either. Certainly wasn't a lateral. Every one of them went backwards.
Yes, it's going to be a horse collar. That's what I thought. 15-yard penalty. I'm not sure what the long discussion was. So it'll be an untimed down from the wherever the penalty's from. Not sure.
Are they going to move it from the spot where the ball
hits? Yeah, they're going to move it. The foul.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
From there.
That's where the dead ball was?
All right. Now we can try
to get
the
field goal.
I didn't know it was the end of the play. I thought it was not a spot foul then. It's from the end of the run. So now we got a chance.
At the 31-yard line.
Yeah, 48-yarder. They're going to try it. You got to. Holy cow. Tables get turned here, and Heversham kicked the winning field goal.
All right, Michael Hill's in there.
He's got the leg for it. I don't think anybody suspected Heversham would have a chance to kick a field goal to win it. They don't have a timeout, Dyson. Just kick it and nail it, Hill.
There's a snap, hold, kick. It's up there, and it's going to be short.
Just didn't quite get all of it. You have to watch yourself here at the end of this game. It could get ugly. Somebody don't need to make a mistake. OK, because the behavior from the white shirts is not very professional right now.
Final score, Haversham lost it 31-29.
That's all coaching right there. You let your team act like that. I'm sorry to say that on the air, but that's a shame right there.